All right, so you start by downloading the fontawesome font. You can do it from fontawesome.io, or you can click this link that I have right here. You can go ahead and download it, fontawesome 4.7.0. It works for PC or Mac, but I'm happen to be using a Mac. So wait for that to download, then open it up. You should have four files, CSS, fonts, less, and CSSS. You want to click fonts and install the fontawesome.odf. So just double click it and then install font. A little bit different for the PC, but same idea, just install that font. So we're going to install checked. All right, and then once that's finished, you're good to go. Open up Photoshop or AI, and then open up your mockup, or in my case, let's just make a new one. Let's do it in 300 DPI. Yep, so basically you're gonna be taking a text and replacing it with fontawesome. So let's just fix the color. All right, it's white. Cool. So you head back over and you're going to go over to the fontawesome cheat sheet. I suggest downloading it, but here's the URL to use it for reference. So from here, you can pretty much find any icon that you've ever seen online. But there's so many, so we're just going to Command F and look for a Facebook icon. So I like this one. I'm just gonna copy it. Just the icon, not the letters. Just copy the icon. And then creating a text layer, we're gonna paste that icon. All right, so sometimes you'll get this weird X. All you do is highlight it and then change the text to fontawesome. And boom, shows up. There's my Facebook icon. So you can do anything with this icon that you can do with text, like change the color to make it the Facebook blue. It's somewhere around there. You can play with the size, you know, make it bigger, smaller, however you want it. You can move it around to anywhere on the page. And, you know, since this is a text file, you can go back and copy another one. Let's say this one. And just like adding another letter to text, you can just paste that in, boom. So you can line things up, make them individual layers, however you want it. They're all pretty much text files. So, I suggest downloading the cheat sheet, because sometimes you may not have internet connection. So I have a link back on this blog post where you can download this cheat sheet. Or if you just want to download this guide so you can reference it or share it with someone else, there's a link at the top of this page also.